Hello children, how are you all? I hope you are all safe and home. Right, welcome to the today's maths class. We are going to discuss that is playing with numbers already up to 3.4 exercise completed. So till now we discussed what are factors, multiples and divisibility rules of different numbers. Clear? As well as common factors, common multiples has been completed. Now let us discuss some more divisibility rules. Okay, so now we are going to discuss some more divisibility rules. In that, see this here, some numbers, see this here, based on this we discussed two problems in the previous exercise, that is in 3.4. Okay, that is question number 6 and 7. So based on that, they introduce some rules. Okay, so first rule is, if a number is divisible by, write down this, rule 1, if a number is divisible by another number, then it is divisible, then it is divisible by each of the factors of that number. Clear, children? So let us take a simple example. Example is nothing but in 3.4 exercise question number 7. Okay, let us take a simple example number. Write a number is divisible by 6. Divisible by 6. Right? So now let us take a number which is divisible by 6. Let us take 18. Okay? So now 18 is divisible by 6. Okay? 18 is divisible by 6. Now write the factors. So what are the factors of 6 here? Factors of 6 is 1, 2, 3, and 6. Okay? So now see this here. 1, 2, 3 and 6 are the factors of 6. What is the rule here? If a number is divisible by another number, then it is divisible by each of the factors of that number. See this here, I'm taking a number 18. Right? 18 is divisible by 6. We know that because 18 is a multiple of 6. So now 18 is divisible by 1 because 1 is a factor of every number, and 18 is an even number, it is divisible by 2. 18 is a multiple of 3, it is divisible by 3 also. Is it clear, children? So this is the example, right? So now you please copy this. Right, let us discuss rule number 2. What is that here? If a number is divisible by 2 co-prime numbers, then it is divisible by their product also. What is mean by co-prime? Co-primes is nothing but two numbers have only one factor. One is the common factor. Okay, so I give the example for co-primes. 2, 3 are co-primes. The common factor is only 1. Okay, 3, 4, 5, 6. But these are all the numbers have one is the common factor. Okay, then those numbers are nothing but co-primes. So here, if a number is divisible by 2 co-prime numbers, then it is divisible by their product also. Here I took 2, 3 are co-primes. Okay, so now let us take a number. Let us take 24. Okay, 24 is divisible by
2 and as well as and 3 also. Because 24 is an even number, it is divisible by 2. Okay, and 24 is a multiple of 3. 3 8 is 24. Right? Now we are going to find out the product of 2 and 3. When you multiply 2 and 3, you will get 6. 6 is also is divisible. See, sir, 24 is divisible by 6 also. Why? Because 24 is a multiple of 6. Is it clear, children? See, look at here. If a number is divisible by 2 co-prime numbers, then it is divisible by their product also. Here 2 comma 3 are co-primes. I am taking one number, that is 24. 24 is divisible by 2 and as well as 3 also. Because 24 is an even number, 24 is a multiple of 2 and as well as 24 is a multiple of 3. And their product 2 and 3, the product of 2, 3 is nothing but 6. 6, that is 24 is also divisible by 6 because 24 is a multiple of 6. Clear, children? Now let us discuss rule number 3. What is rule 3 here? If two given numbers are divisible by, are divisible by a number, right? Then their sum is also divisible by that number. Then their sum is also divisible by that number. Here we are going to take a simple example. If two given numbers are divisible by a number, two numbers, okay, let us take two numbers, both the numbers are divisible by same number. Let us take a simple example. I am taking 10 and 12. So these two numbers are divisible by 2. Okay, let us take a simple example. Divisible by 2. Right? So here the given condition is, then their sum is also divisible by that number. What is sum of 10 and 12? Now sum of 10 and 12, which is equal to 10 plus 12 is equal to 22. 22 is also divisible by 2 because 22 is a even number. Divisible by 2. Is it clear, children? Let us take any two numbers. Both the numbers are divisible by another number. Okay. So then add these two numbers. The sum also divisible by the same number. Here I took 10 and 12 are divisible by 2. Because 2 5s are 10, 2 6s are 12. Then add these two. By adding 10 and 12, you will get 22. 22 is also divisible by 2. Let us take different numbers. 6 and 18 also divisible by 3. Okay. Then add both. See this, sir, I am going to take one more example. 6 and 18 are divisible by 3. Are divisible by 3. Okay. Then get sum. What is sum of 6 and 18? Which is equal to 24. 24 is also divisible by 3. Clear, children? So like that, you can take simple example. Take any simple example. Right? So both the numbers are divisible by the same number. Both the numbers. Then the sum also divisible by the same number. Clear? So write down these two. Right, children. Let us discuss rule number 4. So now, what is that here? If two numbers are divisible by a number, then the difference is also divisible by that number. Previous rule is adding those two numbers. Here we need to subtract those two numbers. Let us take a simple example. Right? 12 and let us take 20. 12 and 20 are divisible by are divisible by 4. Clear? Because 12 is a multiple of 4, 20 is also multiple of 4. So these two numbers are divisible by 4. Now you need to do the difference. Difference means subtraction. Generally, how to do subtraction? Small, big value minus small value. Now difference 20 minus 12 is equal to 8. 8 is also divisible by 4. Is it clear? Divisible by 4. Clear, children? Let us take another example. 25 and let us take 80. 25 and 80 both are divisible by 5. Divisible by 5 because 25, 5 5s are 25 and this will become 16 5s are 80 because ending with 0, 8 plus is 0, then we can say 80 is divisible by 5. Then difference 80 minus 25 is 55. 55 is also divisible by 5 because 11 5s are 55. Divisible by 5. Is it clear, children? So if two numbers are divisible by a number, their sum also divisible by the same number, and as well as difference also divisible by the same number. Is it clear? Note on this. Right, children, let us discuss prime factorization. What is meant by prime factorization? Last year we discussed a factor tree. Did you remember that? In the 5th class, right? So a number can be written as in terms of prime numbers. Okay, here also we are going to discuss prime factorization is nothing but whatever the factors of a number are should be in prime only. Prime numbers only we need to consider. Let us take a simple example. Okay, prime factorization of, let us take 36. So now first of all you should try to 36 can be written as 6, 6 and, okay, 6 and 6. Then 6 can be written as 2, 3 and 2 and 3. Enough. Okay. Here also we can write 2 and 3. Is it clear? So then 36 can be written as, right, only last values. 2 into 3 into 2 into 3. That is 2 into 2, 3 into 3. See this here, if you observe, in this all, the prime factorization of 36, see all you got prime numbers only. 2 and 3 are prime numbers. So we write 36 in terms of 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Multiply all these numbers. 3 3s are 9, 9 2s are 18, 18 2s are 36. This is called prime factorization. Okay? So to write all the factors of the given number in terms of 2 and 3 are 4, only prime numbers. Right? Only prime numbers. Let us discuss one more. So let us discuss 28. Okay, 28 can be written as, first of all, this can be written as 7 4s are 7 and 4. 4 can be written as 2 into 2. Okay, now write only these three last numbers. Okay, so 28 can be written as 2 into 2 into 7. Right, only I need to get here prime numbers only, no other composite number. Only prime number. Even 1 also we should not get here. Only we will get prime numbers only. See this here. 28 can be written as 2 into 2 into 7. 2 is a prime number. 2 is a prime number. 7 is also a prime number. By multiplying these three values, you should get the answer compulsory. 28. 7 2s are 14. 14 2s are 28. Here also. 2 2s are 4. 4 3s are 12. 12 3s are 36. Is it clear, children? This is called prime factorization. Right? Copy this. Right, children, let us discuss exercise 3.5. Okay, in that first question is totally a true or false. Okay, you need to solve that within the textbook only you can write true or false. Okay, now come to the question number 2. Is a factor tree. Write the missing numbers in that textbook itself only. Now coming to the question number 3. Which factors are not included in the prime factorization of a composite number? So now when you write the prime factorization of a given number, which numbers are not included?
Can anyone write? See this here. Let us take a simple example. Question number 3. Write the factors of prime factorization of 24. Now see this here. In 24, I am going to write. This is 6 4s are. Okay. 6 can be as 2 into 3. And 4 can be written as 2 into 2. Okay. So 24 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Now, which numbers are not included in the prime factorization? Right. 1 and a number itself. 1 and 24 are not included in any prime factorization. Is it clear? Other numbers you have to keep aside. Only these two are not included. Sometimes it is here 6, 4, 8, 3, 24, we can write all. But coming to the prime factorization, we did not write 1 and 24. Right? So this is an answer. Clear? So a number, which factors are not included? 1 and a number itself. Clear? Now come to the question number 4. Now, question number 4. It is write the greatest 4 digit number and express it in the form of prime factorization. What is the greatest 4 digit number? That is 9999. Okay, find out the prime factorization of 999. Okay, now question number 5. Now it should be write the smallest 5 digit number. The smallest 5 digit number is by adding 1, you will get a 5 digit number 1, 2, 3, 4. That is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right. That should be 10,000. 10,000 is the smallest 5 digit number. Write the prime factorization of 10,000. Start with 2. Okay. Then 2, then 2, 2, 5. Like that you will get. Clear? Now coming to the question number 6. Find all the prime factors of 1729 and arrange them in ascending order. Now state the relation, if any, between two consecutive prime numbers. Okay, so we need to write the prime factorization of 1729. What is the special of 1729? Can anyone? Yes, 1729 is a special number, that is a Ramanujan's number. Right, 1729. Is it clear? For that we are going to find out the prime factorization. Okay, now question number. Right, children. Let us discuss question number 6. So what is question number 6 here? 1729. We need to write the prime factorization of 1729. And we need to make a relation between two consecutive prime factors. Okay. So now by doing with 7, 7 2s are 14, 3 32, 7 4s are 28, 49, 7 7s are 49. Next 13 table, 13 1s are 13, okay, then 13 9s are 117. So now what is the prime factorization of 1729? So 1729 is equal to 7 into 13 into 19. We are arranging in ascending order. What is meant by ascending order? Small to big. Now see that what is the relation between these three numbers? They are asking that between two consecutive prime numbers, is there any relation? Right. So now what is the relation here? Now see this here, 13 minus 7 is equal to 6 and as well as 19 minus 13 is also 6. Okay, the difference is the difference of two consecutive prime numbers is 6. That is the relation between these numbers. Okay, now please copy this. Right, question number 7. We are going to discuss question number 7. What is the question number 7 here? The product of three consecutive numbers, is always divisible by 6. Verify this with the help of some examples. Consecutive three numbers is nothing but continuation we need to take, like 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, 5. Okay, let us take a simple example. Let the three consecutive numbers
consecutive numbers are, you can take anything. I am going to take 3, 4 and 5. Now I am going to multiply these three. The product of these three consecutive numbers is always divisible by 6. We are going to check it out whether it is. Now 3 into 4 into 5. 5 4s are 20, 23 is a 60. Yes, 60 is divisible by, is divisible by 6. Clear? Let us take another three numbers. Let us take that. Let us take one more. Let us take that other three numbers here. 5, 6, 7. Now we are going to multiply. 5 into 6 into 7. 5, 6 are 30. 37s are 210. Now let us see this here. 210 is divisible by 6 or not. Divide with 6. 6 3s are 18. 3, 30. 6, 5 are 30. Yes, remainder is 0 we got. So this number is also divisible by 6. So you can take any three consecutive numbers. The product of those three numbers is always divisible by 6. Is it clear, children? Right, copy this. Right. Let us discuss question number 8. What is the question number 8? The sum of two consecutive odd numbers is divisible by 4. The sum of two consecutive odd numbers is divisible by 4. Verify this statement with the help of some examples. Sum of two odd numbers. What are the odd numbers here? 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13. All these are all odd numbers. Here they are given consecutive, means continuation, like 1 comma 3 or 3 comma 5 or 5 comma 7. Okay, let us consider two odd consecutive numbers. What are the two consecutive numbers? Let us take any two. Let us take 5 comma 7. Now, the sum is equal to 5 plus 7, which is equal to 12. 12 is divisible by 4. You can take another example. Let us take 13 and 15. Okay, then add 13 plus 15 is equal to 28. 28 is divisible by 4. Right? You can take another number also. You can take another number and you can prove that. So clear, children? Next, 9th question. In which of the following expression prime factorization has been done? Now see, sir, A bit. In A bit, 4 is there in the factorization. So 4 is not a prime number. So A bit is not possible. B bit is, see, all prime numbers only. 7 into 2 into 2 into 2. Right, B is the answer. And C1 is also 2 into 5 into 7. And D1, 9 is there. 9 is a composite number. So B and C are both are having prime factorization. Okay. Now question number 10. Determine if 25110 is divisible by 45 or not. So they given here one hint. If 5 and 9 are co-prime numbers, test the divisibility of the numbers by 5 and as well as 9. 5 and 9. Okay. So now I am going to discuss that question number 10 here. Whether 25110 is divisible by 45. Is divisible by 45 or not. We are going to discuss here. So now, if 5 and 9 are co-primes, a number is divisible by two numbers, that number is divisible by a product of those numbers also. Just now we discussed that rule. Okay. Now, we are going to discuss that. See this here. 25110 is divisible by 5. Why? Because it is ending with 0. In the unit place it has 0, then this number is divisible by 5. Now we are going to check it out whether this number is divisible by 9 or not. So what is the rule of 9? Sum of all the digits. Now 2 plus 5 plus 1 plus 1 plus 0, which is equal to 9. Yes, sir. So 25 110 is divisible by 9. Why? Because the sum of the digits is got 9. 9 is a multiple of 9. So therefore here 25110 is divisible by 5 and 9, then it is also divisible by 45, because their product divisible by 5 into 9, which is equal to 45. Just now we discussed no rules, somewhat divisibility rules, that is a rule number 2. Okay, that rule we are going to apply here. Come on, copy this problem. Right, children, I hope you understood that today's class. That is, we discussed 4 divisibility rules. Clear? And otherwise, we discussed the prime factorization also. And we discussed some problems from the exercise 3.5. And here, today's homework is exercise 3.5, page number 61 and 62, question number 1, 2, 4, 5, 11, and 12. Clear, children? Thank you. Have a great day.